this is another day. What is it about her personal style, how she managed to use it and create an identity, and how you can use it to be able to build your identity and even more than that, your personal brand if you're a creative woman entrepreneur. Where do we start and how do we do it? Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue à mon canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yokoso. Today we're having an episode 2 of Decoding Style, and as you can see by the title, we're gonna talk about Michelle Obama, because guess what? Fashion, personal style, power, identity, and just being gorgeous, it's all about her. She just breathes fashion in such a really good and genuine way. We're gonna dive deep into it, what we can learn about it. But before, a bit about my Decoding Style series. We really identify people's style, celebrity style, or people like Michelle Obama, and we try to take lessons from that and how you can use it and make it better for your life and your business. You didn't know, I'm a personal style coach and I'm passionate about helping creative women entrepreneurs uncover their personal style on a such a deeper level that they're gonna feel 10x million times confident in the business and in the lives. And I'm all about being obsessed by my dear Hello Kitty here. She's my bestie. Being a first lady, the way she did it, she made it more than... Oof, I'm having tears here. But she brought something that I call the soft power. Instead of trying to look like a man, she used her own femininity and she understood right from the get-go what fashion could be and how it could be strategic for her. Being the first black lady at the White House, being the first black couple at the White House, running one of the most powerful countries in this world, she understood that everybody was gonna have eyes on her and her husband. She's still powerful. The power of social media. Because when they entered in 2008, if I remember, for the first time, social media was on rising. So everybody was waiting to see what they were about. Being graduated from Harvard, I mean, I can't say anything more when it comes to it. All of that, she understood how it was important for her to literally embrace an identity, something that she was really believing in, and it was change. It was time to get to another chapter when it comes to the United States, and she was like, you know what? I'm gonna use it to my advantage. And that's the power of clothes. I talk about personal style all the time, but I'm saying it again. You can use it as a tool. But at the same time, she made it amazingly gorgeous because social media nowadays is so much more powerful than anything else. It's almost becoming something political. From the social media, people were gonna talk about her dresses, her outfits, or anything like that. It was gonna be a lot of comments, a lot of sharings. It was gonna be a lot of people talking about it. And you being black, being the first black couple at the White House, you know people are gonna judge you. If people judge you that way, you use it. You use the power of social media. You being smart at doing it, but in a good way, because at the same time, you bring it to such a level that it's still aligned to your personal style. You make it even more powerful. And she even used it to leverage her husband's agenda. We're gonna go into details here now. Let's talk about a couple of dresses, a couple of outfits that she wore, and that I could definitely tell you that it was all strategy behind it and how we can do it ourselves. She made it an art. She made it an art by pairing designers with some countries during state dinners or trips. When dining with Queen Elizabeth II at Buckingham Palace, she decided to go with a designer, Mr. Ford, who is an American designer but is in London. And that was during the second terms of Barack Obama. So many more examples. She decided to use her visibility to be able to host local designers. And you know how hard it is for local designers to even gain that visibility, because she knew it would help them. Even more so, to have an argument against, I don't know how to say it, but I'm gonna say it the best way I can, because hey, speak French first here, isolationism. It was definitely not random for her to wear that amazing, gorgeous Gucci gown dress to the Kennedy Center honors the same day Italy went to the polls to vote on a referendum as a verdict on Matteo Renzi, which was widely viewed. Matteo Renzi then himself is now the country's former reformist prime minister wearing that designer. It was not random at all. We'll go even deeper than that. I talked a lot about colors and the way colors can be a form of therapy for you, but they could be a form of powerful messaging. Talk about the Alexander McQueen dress that she wore for the China State Dinner. Gorgeous organza dress. Her dress was a symbol because in China, red is a symbol of celebration, it's a symbol of luck, it's a symbol of joy. So what she did right there was open the doors for Hu Jintao to be relaxed and be able to listen. Know how China is getting to be really powerful. Michelle Obama here was a political when it comes to it, saying a lot about a person but could be saying a lot about the people you're talking to. She used her clothes, she used her style, not as a uniform, because being in a White House you have to dress up a certain way, but what she did here was embracing that change and need people to see it and to feel it instead of just saying it. She used her clothes not as a uniform but frame her independence. I'm powerful, I know what I'm doing, but I'm still feminine. All of that had a purpose, all of that had a strategy behind it, but again it was a part of her personal style, because when she was ordering clothes the designers didn't even know if it was for her personal use or if it was for any type of official or political matters. She didn't try to look a certain way, it was a part of her human beingness, if I could say it like that. When being asked how much she was spending on her wardrobe, she was like, I'm ordering from brands like J. Crew. You can find them online, but not anymore because, well, they filed for bankruptcy. She was not buying anything necessarily super expensive at for her level, obviously. She wore a lot of different designers. Everything that she was feeling was a part of her personal style. So let's say you're a creative woman entrepreneur and you're trying to stand out on social media. A lot of competition already, and you want to make it remembered. You want to make it something that people are gonna be naturally drawn to. People's head, people's mind. People thinking about you all the time. The first thing you need to know here is that you need to find your purpose, find your why. Because when Michelle Obama decided to wear whatever she was wearing, she knew what was gonna be the result of that. She embraced the change. She became contemporary, so younger people could look up to her. She knew the power of social media. She knew people were gonna talk about her being the first black lady. Just to start with, it was a blog chronicling about her clothes for the whole presidency, for both terms. She didn't just say, I want to change, I want to change stuff, I want to do everything. She talked about it, but she walked the talk, embracing that style, which was already something that came from her. You trying to stand out on social media, trying to find that voice, find your purpose. Let's say you want to be minimalistic, or let's say you want to be, you are a vegan into not killing animals. The last thing you would do is to show yourself online in videos and having to wear a leather jacket. It's not happening. People are not gonna believe you. People can smell when you're not being real. People could smell if it's not your true purpose. So you need to believe in first for people to believe in it as well. You need to be able to have it deeply, deeply as the core of your cause, whatever you're fighting it, for people to be naturally drawn to it. Because some other ladies like Sophie Gabrielle Trudeau, Justin Trudeau's wife, who's the Prime Minister of Canada, tried to do it, but it was not working as much as the way Michelle Obama did it. It was not about just mixing, matching pieces in the wardrobe. It was much more than that. Michelle Obama was embracing a change, an idea, and she was targeting a specific population here, younger generation. 90% of our communication goes through the visual, even more so with the power of social media nowadays, because a lot of people are leveraging videos, a lot of people are showing themselves on video, and all of that is because people, when they see you, when they can listen to your voice, this is something they can feel from you. If it's fake, if it's real, if it's something that you're trying to copy paste here, gonna be fast. With the visual, people can see who you are, what you are about, and what you're fighting for. If you're saying that you're fighting for something, and it doesn't have to be something big, it doesn't have to be you fighting against cancer, unless you want to. it has to be something that is really true to you, that means something to you. People can see it, be drawn to it. Not. This is the power of repelling and attracting the right people for you. So whenever you're trying to have that personal branding, especially if you're really on the visual and showing up yourself on video more and more, here is the power of bridging. I talked a bit about it in the video that I'm gonna link somewhere here. Your audience. Michelle knew her audience. It was the younger generation, it was millennials. People like me. A lot of people like my age. She's all about educating the younger generation, educating the younger woman to be able to be the best versions they can possibly be using their femininity. Instead of trying to use the clothes without having a purpose and without having an intention, set intentions when it comes to your wardrobe. Make it a part of your personal style. It's gonna be genuine that way. And you go to an interview. Usually, I mean, that's something that I would always suggest for people that maybe didn't do it before. It's actually make the research on the companies you're gonna have an interview to. Branding on the website, you can know. The colors are gonna tell you a lot of things. If it's a startup, it's gonna be a little bit more relaxed, but it's not necessarily in PJ here. And not necessarily close to that. No jogging pants, by the way. Blazer, good at having that balance when you pair it with something else that is gonna be a little laid back. But if it's something much more corporate, you know you're gonna have to be a little bit more dressed up, a little bit more corporate. Being a lawyer, for example, it's not the time for you to look like a rainbow. You have to be suited up. So you have to walk the talk. You need to be able to do your research before it. Even the person you're gonna have an interview with, we can do that so easily today with LinkedIn. You know what the person is about. You know you can talk about a certain things, not just about the company, but having it super subtle. And we women really go that way. The power of bridging. Know your audience, know people you're talking to here. Soft power. I'm so big about being feminine and so big against trying to compete to men. Strongly believe that you being a woman, you have your strength. Know your strength. That intuition we're having as women, we have the power of creating emotional connections that most men can't. And see all the shades. In general, it's like black, white. Lighter gray, lilac. Go to a man's place. Go to a man, an African man. Hey, I said it. African men have that macho in them that make them. Telling you, men are straight to the bullet. You trying to grow your personal brand in a world where women are being much more successful, and even more so, you targeting women. You have to have that emotional connection. Don't try to compete to a man. You're better than that. Being feminine. The power of feminine can go beyond being powerful just like men are. This is the soft power. And I'm gonna talk about it even more when it comes to the rising of Korean culture, the Korean power with the Korean pop and the K-dramas. Get ready for it because, ooh, I have a lot to say. Other thing about wearing designer coming from the same country, state dinner had, have a way of starting up a conversation because you don't know the person in front of you. And usually the man, they're gonna talk about this stuff, and the woman, the first lady is there, they're gonna have to talk about something, or at least to start talking about something. And usually when you don't know each other, you guys are not friends. See yourself being on an event where you don't know anybody, and you go into that networking event to maybe have a collaboration, find potential partners, or find potential clients. Dress up a certain way where you know you can strike up conversations. And if you're shy, it's even better for you because you bring certain things, it's gonna draw people to you. And people are gonna start asking you questions. Make it relaxing, not having to always be on the political plan, strategic plan. Light it up a little bit. And then at that point, you can even start talking about something much more serious. They're gonna be a lot more comfortable talking about it. Sometimes we think being on social media, you always have to think about just the thing you want to talk about. So let's say you're personal style coach like me, you're gonna talk about fashion all the time, you're gonna talk about style all the time. But people want to see the real you as well. People want to see who you are about as well, besides being a personal style coach. Who you are about. That's a way to start up that conversation. I love Hello Kitty, she's my baby here. I love anime, I'm obsessed by Japanese anime, I'm obsessed by Asian, I love drawing mangas. Living here, speaking many languages, and being there with you and talking about Michelle Obama. I'm all of that. I love dancing, this is my I'm really big into that, and you can see that on my Instagram. Just follow me, because nowadays, being contemporary, trying to get millennials, for example, they want to know that. I love talking about the fashion, I love talking about the confidence, because to me, they're all the same. Personal style is just a way to showcase yourself to the world, but it's by building up that confidence first. What you are about is really important for you to draw people in. What decoding style is, that you have around you and people that you look up to, and look through them and see how they do it. You need to work on to building that confidence. All of that comes even more amplified with the clothes you're gonna have on you. This is the beauty and the magic behind it. I really hope you love this analysis. For me, honestly, she was one of the most remembered ones. Jacqueline Kennedy, Nancy Reagan were definitely other icons at that point. Let me know what you liked most about it. And do you love Michelle Obama's style? And if you do, why? And what can you learn from whatever you heard here today? I want to know more about it in the comment section down below. I have a free 30-minute chat call just right down below. There's gonna be a link, so if you want to talk in private, definitely do. I want to know more about you. I want to know who you are about as a person. If you want to build a personal branding for 2020, well, you got the main things you can start doing from now on. So, 2020 is the year, 2020 is your year, so let's just crush it. For the time being, I'm gonna see you on another video. Follow me on Instagram, subscribe to that channel, because, well, there's gonna be more, obviously. This is just the second episode. And if you have any other idea of people that I can talk to the style, and when it comes to the mindset part of it, definitely let me know down below. Soon to be coming, I'm gonna talk about Channel Money, because I think she is crushing it with her style, but more so, she made it a part of her being bisexual. Analyze what you can learn from that and how you can have it on your own style if it's a part of you. I'm gonna see you on my next video, and comme je dis toujours, le mot de la fin, smile, because it's free and contagious. Bye.